Hey, Ray.
Hey, Ray.
What's up, Ray?
I thought I ran the town. What's going on?
You're employee of the month.
In conjunction with Mrs. Yotata Miller, Menashe's wife, Mayor's wife, just want to let the mayor know that he's going to be missed when he leaves us in about 7 to 10 days from an undisclosed location in the Middle East, where he's going to be serving a tour of duty with the United States Air Force. We seem to be doing this annually, and we're trying to get it to be like for 6 months instead of just 1 month, but right now we'll be going over for another week tour of duty like he did last year during the holiday season. With that, we'd like to continue our meeting. Ivar?
All right.
First of all, I'd like to thank Mayor Lipinski and Mrs. Miller for putting together this wonderful presentation. You're not going to be here at the next meeting, and you know there was talk that perhaps you could even miss the first meeting of the year. And I really wanted to reserve my comments for the first meeting of the year, you know, as the outgoing or incoming mayor, whatever that may be, you know, for next year. But I think that what we'll have to do this year, perhaps, is to use the same trick with the Air Force that we did this year in order to get you back here, and that's to tell them that we're making you the mayor again and that you just have to be here for reorganization. That you can miss the reorg meeting. Just so everyone knows, so if I may just set aside, we are planning for January 3rd. We hope that Menashe is back by then, but if he's not, we'll make sure to tell the Air Force that he has to be back before the end of the week, because that's when we have to put it back in as a mayor. I would just like to say much that we had a lot of discussions before you became mayor, and we had a lot of discussion before I became mayor, and it was certainly your right to be mayor especially we had the five in general main that. I just want to say how much I enjoyed watching this in New York show this year. All the concerns and all the things that we discussed about all went out the window on Saturday night. And you have done, in my opinion, you have done a wonderful job as the mayor. You have brought a sense of, we always talk about how no matter how much Lakewood grows, you know, we still want to make it feel like a small town. You certainly bring that to the committee, and you certainly bring that to the residents of the town. You give people a very good feeling that they feel that they're very well connected and very closely connected to the community. I can say nothing more than that. I'm so proud of what you've accomplished as a mayor and what you've done in the wheelchair, especially in some of the trying moments that we had this year, especially when we saw some of the pictures here with Officer Maxwell and like that. But, the way you handle that, the way you represent the Lakewood, couldn't ask for anybody else. I don't think anybody else could have done a better job than you did handling some of the tough, difficult situations that we had this year. And I just commend you for the job that you've done. I wish you a good luck, Godspeed, and a safe tour of duty overseas. And seriously, to be back in time for New York to be the mayor again next year.
Yeah, Menashe, this is something I told you in private, and I'm going to say it publicly. On behalf of myself and the entire Lakewood, I thank you for never sleeping, never eating, and never being anywhere other than where the township needs you. I've never heard from you that you're too busy to speak to me about anything, and although everybody to my left has helped me a lot over the course of the year, some of them sleep, some of them eat, some of them work. And I never had an excuse out of you that you couldn't help me, and I never had a time where you couldn't make the time for me within a very reasonable amount of time. And I know you do that for a lot of people in Lakewood. far for another community. We all have to be committed to service, and we have to treat everybody with respect because of how you treat everybody. And I know from walking the walls of the township that the employees respect you a lot, and I appreciate everything. I don't have much to compare with the only mayor I served with, but I think you did a phenomenal job, and thank you very much.
Thank you. Manassas, a real privilege this year to serve with you as the mayor. I remember several years ago at the organization meeting, ultimately had the opportunity to serve with you as mayor, and it was everything that I hoped for. It was a great experience. You've done a tremendous job. I know it's like to sit in that center chair, and how hard it is sometimes to keep your cool, to keep things going on an even keel. And I have to say that I've never seen anybody handle himself with as much grace, goodwill, and good humor as you have this year. It's an incredible accomplishment, and I'm proud to be able to serve with you. We're going to miss you. I mean, I know how hard it is for you to leave. I know your family will miss you tremendously. We will, too. I know I, for one, won't sleep quite as well, but I know that you're home safe with us again. I pray this is time for January 1st. I just hope that you're overseas. You can convey some of that goodwill, that good humor and grace to the folks over there. Thank them for the sacrifices that they're making on our behalf, and thank you for that sacrifice as well. So good luck. Godspeed. I can't wait to see you back home.
Last time that you were there, I was reading the email that you sent me. It was a picture of Mayor, or then Deputy Mayor Miller, and Major Patton, sitting back in the sun. He was wearing a bulletproof vest, smiling, going like this. How's the snowstorm, Mayor? So I remember when you sent that to me, and of course it was all in good humor, but that certainly, all jokes aside, was probably a bit more of a dangerous situation. The mayor did tell me that he's looking for long repairs to come with him to the Middle East to check the streetlights there. So, or to comment presentations. He either has to be streetlights or presentations during those 3 weeks. He won't be able to last all 3 weeks without it. But seriously, Mayor, it was such a pleasure serving under you this year and working with you. And again, like Isaac said, you always made time to be available for us and set the bar for us. I mean, your own personality here in town hall and working with people and the respect that you give to people and the respect that you automatically command in return, because we know that when you show respect to somebody and show your love and appreciation for somebody, that always gets mirrored back. We're going to miss you. I'm sure your family's going to miss you. Your parents, your children are here. They're invited again to meet for the Hanukkah party like we did last year, where my wife stuffed up a dummy doll to look like Manash and put it up ahead of the day. But of course, our praise God for your sacred heart, and we commend you for your service to our township and to our country. We're going to miss you. You want me to turn the meeting back over to you? Listening to my colleagues,
Health Committee, and there's no way, there's absolutely no way that we've been able to do this here today, if not for each and every one of you. Come on. Health, all right, Lydia Ackerman, fresh blood, new insight, a fresh look to the committee, various things, various ideas. It's always when a person's a resident living in a town, and they don't necessarily have the opportunity to see things in the bigger picture. Sometimes it's just your block or your area. And sometimes it's so important for those of us sitting up here to hear that from the resident, because sometimes they can see something that we miss. And I, being the newcomer, so to speak, on the committee, you brought that perspective to us. It was certainly very much appreciated. And we're able to act upon and utilize those insights. And even on the media right there, Mayor Lehman, you were the individual who brought fiscal stability for Lakewood. You sat down, you crunched numbers, constantly and consistently sitting down, sharpening the pencil, and allowing us to be able to enjoy the zero tax increase that we've had. You sat in confidence, you certainly find the choices that are not easy to be made. But that was your calling, and you made that your mission. And even tonight, we finished executive session, because we brought up our state ready on next year's budget and trying to come up with ways to be able to minimize the tax burden of the residents. It's certainly something, again, I can't say that I did that. That was something that you brought to the prior committee and showed us the way. Honorable Mayor Ray, I was put on honorable as it says that it's the fathers whose honor you honor, he honors other people. Ray Cole was the person when I first came on the committee. Ray was one of the youngest ones at the time. And Luke showed me every step of the way. He had a care for the single person. Had to be able to focus and zoom in and see the person that has his issue. And sometimes when we look at different issues, we classify some issues. That's a big issue. That's a small issue. It's like, you know, there was once a little boy who was complaining to his mother about the shoes. The mother says, well, there are some people that don't have feet. Yeah, but the person who doesn't have feet, his problem is the shoes. Each person has their problem, and no matter how big or how small it is, to that person, this problem is larger than life. And that's something you, Honorable Ray, have taught me, that each person's issue is as big as life, and we have to look at each person for who they are, and be able to give to that person what his issue is. I'll never forget this thing before I came into the committee. I just want to let you know, we were talking about it. You said to me, you're going to have a lot of hard time with this. What do you mean? And he told me, he said, so I got a phone call from this guy, my neighbor at home, or someone else, maybe there's an issue, or something comes in and says, if you don't have a shoe, what did I say? Every single person who's here is going to come up to us. It's just the way it is that people that know you are always going to come over to you. And of course, that's such an important thing, and I appreciate from day one showing you how to care for the single person, for each and every person by yourself. Committee of Lichtenstein, I always say this, Mayor Lichtenstein, his parents always believe he's destined for greatness, and he's the mayor. Despite the fact whether he's in the middle chair or not, we always call him Mayor. Mayor has always been the person who always looking to the future. As they always say, as they always talk, who is the person who's knowledgeable, he looks to the future. The rest of the world looks to the future. And he's always the person who had the foresight on his personal constant volunteering and always out. I'll never forget, we were sitting up here some three rows back, killed over, and literally, you know, sort of right over the top, ran out there, took care of the person. That's something where we constantly serve, whether it's in his capacity of the EMP or his capacity being here in Town Hall and assisting the residents. Mayor has always been, on a personal level, and by my family when I was out there, making them always feel it, and my dad wasn't around, but at least they were part of the family, certainly very much appreciated. And for the residents, those of us sitting here this evening, I apologize for taking your time. Many of you have come here to see the UD checks. Trust me, I also didn't know about this presentation, so I would also come a little later. So I forgive you for that, but I'm speechless. I'm actually speechless. I'm usually the one who tries to pull off big events, stunts, and you guys got me. Whoever put that in, my wife had a lot to do with this. I'm speechless. I being a mother, running the show, and taking care of stuff, and always helping you with things, whether it's a town, and then having time to pull this together, I don't know, weirdly how to create this, the strength to be able to constantly, consistently, go long beyond the call of duty put together. I am blown away. I'm blown away. I walk into this night. I walk downstairs, and as we walk, I'm walking together with on the way both of them. I'm coming into the area, and I see a color dog here. I look at Rand, and I'm like, what's going on? He's me. And I walk in here, and I see Chief in uniform. I was like, what's going on here? And I said, looking around, it's my parents, my okay, something's up. That's when I realized that it's all the best one. You guys down here. I'll be back. With regard to the service of the military, I said this to the first time, I say it again now. I'm not going to ask you, Evan, or the Yamato. My great-grandparents, great-great-great-grandparents, and many years back, were persecuted in various countries. The United States of America was the country to allow us to live freedom, to allow us to follow our beliefs, and to allow us to follow our religion. It is incumbent upon us to give back to the country. I felt it as a mission and responsibility to give back to the country by joining, to show appreciation for what they've done for us. It's my mission to give back to this great country that has allowed us to serve this freedom. Going overseas during the holiday season is certainly something which is, during the holiday season, it's not an easy time. Probably the hardest time for our men and women that are overseas, away from the families, for our loved ones, families. And I'm the lucky one, because I'm still for a few weeks and I come back. But they're there for 6 months, a year. They are the true heroes, away from their families, away. It's a brother, it's a sister, it's a daughter, it's a son. And some of them don't come back. It's the reality of life, and they're the real heroes, the unsung heroes. And they go away and they don't find out. I thank you all for coming out here this evening and certainly being part of this. And I'd like to propose that any time we find out anyone in Lakewood Township who's been overseas, fought in the military, and come back, we bring them here to Town Hall, and we let them know how much we appreciate them. We bring their families here and tell them, thank you. Thank you for allowing us to live in the land of the free because of those that are brave. Thank you. I apologize to my immediate family for times I've missed various functions and events. The year of duties I have here at Town Hall, the year of duties of being overseas. I apologize to my three daughters that are here this evening, Essie, Indy, and Sari. I apologize for not being here at the time. I'm wrapped in presence without me. Blue sky. But it's not the same. And I appreciate your support. I appreciate the support that you give. And it's not just for me, and it's not just for us, it's the entire United States, but those that are from the world. I really appreciate it and thank you for that. To my mother and father that are here this evening, I appreciate you coming out here. I know Thursday night's always people to anybody, the Shabbos to anybody, that's always the night for busy night, and I know coming out here this evening, even though it's late, but I know it's kind of hard, and I appreciate you coming out here. I don't know how you guys will have to see for me, but you did a good job, and I'm blown away. And thank you for that. Thank you very, very much. Thank you all for coming.